and accused of beating a woman with a baseball bat. That beating has forever changed that young lady's life. Larry Yellen is live outside the courthouse at 26 in California with more on what's going on today. Larry.
Darlene, the prosecution gave its opening statement this morning. It lasted about 20 minutes or so. It was very emotional. And the defense just finished giving its opening remarks a few minutes ago. Prosecutor Margaret O'Garrick described how before Natasha McShane was beaten, she was one of the thousands of young people from around the world for whom Chicago has become a beacon of light. And she described Heriberto Viramontes as a member of Chicago's ugly underbelly and how his attack on the two women reflected a mixing of these two cultures. McShane's parents and her brother and sister watched from the second and third rows. The Viramontes family also sitting just 15 feet away across the aisle. In the defense's opening today, they claimed, and the you can see behind me now the family of Natasha McShane leaving for lunch. In the defense's opening today, the defense argued that Heriberto Viramontes was not the attacker in this case. They said he has been misidentified, that in fact, Stacey Jurek, one of the two victims in this case, described the attacker as a black male, and Heriberto Viramontes does not fit that description. Stacey Jurek will be the first witness on the stand this afternoon, and she will be followed either this afternoon or tomorrow by Natasha McShane's mother. Very dramatic testimony. Two of the key prosecution witnesses expected to open this afternoon. Back to you, Darlene.
Larry, quick question before we let you go. Yesterday was an interesting day because you had a city official that was part of that jury pool over there. Tell everybody what happened with that one.
Well, when we showed up for jury selection yesterday, among the potential jurors was Circuit Court Clerk Dorothy Brown. She arrived in the morning around 9 a.m. with all of the other jurors. She sat all day long until past 5:30, only to find out that she was not to be selected as one of the 16 jurors, 12 regulars and 4 alternates, who will be deciding this case. She was released, and I presume she'll get the payment that you get for showing up for one day's worth of jury duty at 26th in California.
And then she'll understand what everybody else is talking about. Thank you so much.
First-hand view.
There you go. Larry Yellen over at the Criminal Courts Building.